Welcome to another tech quickie about how to install a resource pack or a data pack. Today we're going to install them from vanilla tweaks, but the same process applies to other resource and data packs. Now first, what is the difference between a resource and a data pack? A resource pack is something that applies just to you as a player. So for example, if you want to have the green grass texture on the side of a dirt block, or if you want to have clear glass without the stripes in it, so this one just applies to you as a player. Whereas a data pack applies to your world, or if you play on a server, to your server. So for example, if you have fast leaf decay installed, then it applies to everybody that plays on this world, not only to you. Now let's go ahead and install a resource pack. Now here you can select one or multiple packs that you would like. So let's just go with the bushy leaves and let's grab something else that I don't have yet. So as you can see, I now selected two different ones and I'm going to click download. And it's going to bring us to this add page where we have to wait for 6 seconds. And then we click on skip. Now as you can see, everything is being downloaded in the bottom left corner. Once it's downloaded, pull it onto your desktop and open up your .minecraft folder. If you don't know where your .minecraft folder is, go into the search bar and type in %appdata%. That brings you into the roaming folder and then you will find the .minecraft folder in the first place. In here, you can open up resource packs and you can drag this zip file in here. Now, if you want to make it easier on yourself, you can rename this one here so that you know what exactly it is. Now, of course, you can download each resource pack separately so that you don't have a bundle, because in here we have the bushy leaves, but we're also having the tool diminishing. Now let's start up Minecraft and make sure everything works. And as you can see, currently we have the standard leaf textures. So if you go into your menu, into the options, and then into the resource pack, you can now click and add the bushy leaves to your selected. Once you click done, it is going to reload everything. And as you can see, now we have bushy leaves on all of our trees. Next, let's go and install some data packs. Now, in vanilla tweaks, you also can find the crafting tweaks, and the crafting tweaks are similar to installed in the data packs. The only difference is the crafting tweaks you don't have to unzip. Now, on a data pack side, you can find things that are going to improve the quality of life. And you can find a lot of things that you probably seen in some YouTube videos, like for example, Hermitcraft. If we look at, for example, mobs, silence mob or more mob heads, double shulker shells, those are all things that the hermits are playing in their server. Now, to install a data pack, all you have to do is click on the data pack or data packs that you want. I'm just going to select one that I haven't installed yet, and you are clicking on download again. Here we are going through the same steps, wait until the 6 seconds are done, and then click on skip. Once it's downloaded, you pull it over onto your desktop again, and again, open up your .minecraft folder. Once you have it on your desktop, open it up and pull each of the data packs onto your desktop. Next, we are going into our .minecraft folder and open up the saves. And in the saves, you can find all of your worlds that you currently have. I'm going to open up my survival world. And in here, you can find the data packs. Once you have the data pack folder open, we are taking the file that we just got out of our vanilla tweak zip folder. And then you click and hold the right mouse button and drag it over. Once it is over, you click on extract. And you can see we now have the extracted cauldron concrete file in here. So that means if I go into my 1.16 survival world, we now have this data pack applied. Once we're in the world, let's try and see if this data pack is working. And I believe I have some concrete powder over here. So I grab a stack of the powder, stand onto the cauldron and drop it in. And as you can see, I now have black concrete instead of the powder. So that means this data pack is working. Thank you for watching this tech quickie. And if you want to see more videos like that, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you and goodbye.